All right, as you know, last night we had a shooting near the Bob Kerrey Pedestrian Bridge. This occurred at about 1:45 a.m. Early this morning. This involved a juvenile that was shot. He is critically injured and being treated at this time. And we do have a juvenile suspect in custody for this incident. I'd be happy to answer any questions that you might have.
Can you clarify? I think that victim is 20, right? Born in 1999?
Yes.
And this juvenile victim, do you know male or female?
I do not know. I don't have that information with me right now.
You guys are up in security, right, as a result of this and probably other similar events in the last couple weeks. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. As the Jean Leahy Mall closed and kind of some of the patterns of pedestrian flow have changed in the downtown market area. We're kind of adjusting our patrol patterns to fit where the people are going and congregating and those kinds of things. So obviously the pedestrian bridge is going to be one of those areas. We are upping our patrols in those areas. We will have additional uniform patrol officers in those areas. We already have a riverfront patrol unit that is strictly patrols the downtown area, the old market, the riverfront, around the convention center and those areas. So they will spend more time in the pedestrian bridge area and other areas that we identify where people are starting to gather as it gets warmer out. We will have additional units such as gang unit officers in these areas. There is already a limited system of security cameras in the bridge area. We're using those right now, reviewing those for evidence from the shooting last night. But the city is also expanding its security camera program in this area. This was already, my understanding, this is already in the works with the Parks Department to expand cameras across the entire length of the bridge and also increase LED lighting across the entire span of the bridge. In the meantime, we are going to explore some portable lighting solutions in the area, especially leading up to the College World Series, to try to brighten up any dark spots that might exist and hopefully deter people from gathering in those areas, or at least causing issues in those areas.
Are these extra security measures, are they going to be more temporary, or are you guys thinking more long term?
Well, I mean, we certainly have the riverfront unit, which it's a pretty good size unit for the small area that it patrols downtown. I think it's more with them, it's more of a adjustment to where they are patrolling, because there's been kind of some changes in where people are gathering. So that's long term. We always have the ability to add additional officers to that patrol unit and then have the gang unit officers supplement that as well. We are also using our gang intelligence unit to monitor social media in real time and provide information to the officers out on the street as to what kind of potential threats they might be seeing.
Is there any indication that this last shooting was gang related?
We don't have that information quite yet. That's still kind of in the early stages. I would just note that a lot of shootings in Omaha, they usually involve individuals that know each other or have some kind of relationship to one another.
You mentioned you were going to make a few adjustments anyway with the Jean Leahy Mall reconfiguration. Were you guys already considering extra security net measures near the bridge, or was this all pushed after the couple incidents that occurred?
Well, not necessarily just near the bridge. It's a matter of adjusting to, like I said, how people are, where they're going, because a lot of people used to gather in the area around the Jean Leahy Mall. And it was just, it's mainly a matter of now that we've had some warm days and warm weekends, where are people, especially younger people, going to tend to congregate during the summer months, and then adjusting our patterns to those sets of facts.
Is the bridge somewhere like an area where people go at night to just hang out, or is that what it's become?
Well, I mean, it certainly can be. It's not like our other city parks have a designated closing time, usually 11 p.m. The bridge does not. It stays open. So I think it tends to be a place where people go late at night and tend to gather and hang out. So I think that's just an area that we're gonna have to watch late at night. Like this was nearly 2 o'clock in the morning. Obviously a lot of younger people that are out late or even people maybe after closing the bars might be an area to go to hang out. So it's definitely an area that we'll keep an eye on.
Obviously you're telling people you don't want them to go out there at those time of hours. I mean, no one should be wandering across a bridge 2 in the morning, right?
Well, they're certainly free to. If they're law abiding and not doing anything wrong, they certainly have that right. We're just encouraging people to be aware of their surroundings and be smart about what they're doing and where they're parking their cars, where they're hanging out, what's going on around them. If they see some kind of disturbance, obviously call 911 and maybe consider going to a different area.
You say you had a suspect in custody?
We do have a suspect in custody for the shooting that occurred at the bridge.
How did you apprehend him?
That suspect was apprehended by uniformed patrol officers. They were fairly close to the area when the shooting call came out. They arrived on scene, and my understanding is that the suspect was attempting to hide and was captured in that process.
Were there other people in that group? Was there a group? Or?
I don't have that information.
Do you know why the victim was out there?
I do not know why.
Was it just 3 weeks earlier two men jumped another man and he stabbed them? Was that just a couple weeks ago? So is this area becoming like...
That particular incident, I don't know about. We have had other incidents on the bridge in the past years, but I don't... I couldn't give you a specific number or any firm details about them.
Do you know if the Council Bluffs Police Department assisted at all?
I do not know.
I know a few, about a year ago from now, or last year rather, the extra security measures were put in place after the Old Market shooting. Are
right.
those security measures still there, or was that kind of brushed aside after a while?
Well, I mean, I wouldn't say brushed aside. I mean, we have a certain number of resources and we have to allocate them where we're seeing the issues occurring. And if an issue, if we're seeing lots of disturbances or maybe fights after bar closings or things like that, obviously we're going to address those by sending resources there. If those problems subside, we're going to have to readjust and reallocate our resources. I would just say, kind of like I explained before, that shooting last year occurred kind of along the mall where we were seeing lots of people gather. So we just have to adjust and reallocate those resources that we have to best suit what the public needs.
Were you guys fully staffed last night?
Well, I don't know what fully staffed means, and I honestly can't really answer what.
A quick response, though, right?
Yeah, it was the officers were fairly nearby and were able to get there obviously quick enough to arrest the suspect.
We'll take one more question.
Should people be afraid to be down there at night?
No, I don't think so. I mean, like I pointed out before, most of this has to do with groups of juveniles that are hanging out late at night. I think there are relatively few incidents and people should feel confident in being in the downtown area, in the Old Market, the pedestrian bridge area, wherever they go. I mean, we're going to have lots of officers out, be visible. And as I indicated before, a lot of these incidents have to do with individuals that know each other. Obviously, if they're in a shooting situation, there is a threat to bystanders. We want to prevent any kind of shooting situation that we can. I mean, currently we're down over 25% in shootings for the year, which is pretty substantial considering last year was a record low in shootings. We're down almost 40% in homicides considering last year was a record year in the low number of homicides. So we just want to keep those trends going, deploy our resources where they're most needed, and ensure that the public is safe in all these situations.
All right, thank you.
What's your name, sir?
Scott Gray, G-R-A-Y, Deputy Chief.
Thank you.